Hello everybody, it's Jen, Scrapbena Creations. I have a 10-card video today using the Doodlebug So Punny, the chit chat and the odds and ends, along with the 6x6 paper pad. If you want to grab this collection, you can do so using my coupon code JEN10 at the Not Too Shabby Shop, and I will leave the link in the description box below. So we've already jumped into card number one. I'm using Distress Oxide in Worn Lipstick. I'm going to use my Distress Sprayer here to add a little bit of distressing with water. And I obviously skipped through that piece in the editing, but waited, you know, some time for that water to react with the Distress Oxide ink, and then used a cloth to soak up that excess water so that you can see the watermarks as I'm putting it here on the card base. So you will see this rectangle die a lot in this video. I think the stitch rectangle dies are probably my favorite. This card here is going to be using all of the little breakfast foods because they were my absolute favorite in this collection. So I used a little piece of the breakfast food paper. It's kind of like a, you know, one of those like vinyl, what would you call it? Like a design tablecloth you can get at the dollar store. Like that's kind of the look I was going for here, so that they're kind of all lined up on the kitchen table. And I've got the Pop-Tart. I'm going to pop up the little piece of bacon, then I've got the piece of bread with the butter on it, the waffle, and the little fried egg. And I died when I saw these two little sayings, the "don't go bake in my heart," and then the little egg saying, "I couldn't if I fried." I mean, I was singing that song for a good half an hour after I was done making this card. So you might be able to tell I'm still a bit sick. If you didn't see my last video, I'm struggling with that winter cold. We'll see how this video goes. I'm not sure I'll be able to pull through a whole 25 minute of speaking, so I may have to throw some music on, but I will try my best to do a full voiceover as always. So I'm just trying to get everything in place here. I did pop up both of the little beach bubbles here with the different, and I had forgotten to take the release paper off, kind of helps to stick it to the card. And then I'm going to finish this off with some glossy accents on the butter on both the bread and the waffle, and then the yolk part of the egg, and card number one will be done, and we can move on to card number two, which features these little limes, which, oh my goodness, talk about stinking cute. So this is a really bright, cheery card. I'm using an oval die from MFT. Same with the scalloped rectangle die there. It's from the Blueprints 27. And then this piece of yellow cardstock I pulled from my stash, I just cut down to A2 size, which is 4¼ by 5½. So all of these cards are A2 size cards, and I use pre-made card bases from Joann. So I just wanted a little bit of pop of color behind that pretty kind of confetti-like paper, and then this little pink oval has little hearts on it. It's so sweet, and I thought it brought out the pink cheeks in the lime. So I'm just trying to figure out where I want this. I don't know why I decided I might want it somewhere else besides the middle, but originally I wanted it in the middle and that's where it ended up. So I just wanted to make sure that I got that good and adhered down, so I used a stamp block. I'm going to fishtail this little sentiment here that says "Lime Yours," which is adorable. And then I'm going to just simply put these down on the oval. So I did pop up the two lime pieces, well, the full lime and the lime slice on some foam adhesive, and then I'm just going to glue the sentiment banner right onto the oval piece there. I'm not going to pop that up at all. To finish off the card, I brought in some hearts here. These are Illustrated Faith. I've had these in my stash for a while. And when I do these 10 card videos with Doodlebug, I do like to try to use up some things in my stash. So I felt like this pop of bright blue tied in with the confetti and just brought another pop of color, which I really loved. So this is actually one of my favorite cards. I think it's absolutely adorable. So now that we're done card number 2, we can go on to card number 3. And who can resist the Pop-Tart in this collection? So I'm using my wonky stitch die here from MFT. And I'm going to use my X-Acto knife here. And I'm going to put a slit into the toaster. So my little toaster strudel or Pop-Tart can look like it's popping out of the toaster. And the sentiment for this one is, I love you from the bottom of my tart. Which, again, seriously, could they get any cuter? So because that paper is mostly white, it's got very tiny dots on it, I felt like the card base needed a little something, but I didn't want something too bright. So I decided to get out the worn lipstick again, and I'm just very lightly using the distress ink on the card base here, and then I'm going to adhere this panel directly onto the card base. And I think that that just gave it enough color to decipher from the piece of paper. And I also used the worn lipstick to distress the edges of the speech bubble, which really helped. I had, before I turned the camera on, I thought maybe I'd back it up with black, but it was just too black. And so that pink really, it just gives it enough. Like, you can't see it as much on the video, but when you look at it in front of you on the card, it definitely gives it enough distance from that. That's not the right word, but my sick brain can't think of the right word, but it just gives a little bit of color enough that it separates it. That's the word I was looking for. It separates it from that back panel. So to finish off this card, I'm just putting on 3 of the hearts that came in the odds and end pack, and then I'm going to get out my glitter brush marker. This is Spectrum Noir. It's clear, and I'm going to put that on the hearts and on the icing for the Pop-Tart, and that's card number 3 done. So moving on to card number 4, I decided to use this sewing machine and the little spools of thread. So again, my stitched rectangle die is making its appearance. I think it probably made an appearance on 8 out of 10 of these cards, I'm gonna guess. I wanted to have a little border at the bottom there, and then I decided to use a stitched circle and just didn't cut it all the way, and that's gonna be the backdrop for my sewing machine. But I love this heart paper because it reminds me of a quilt. Now the sewing machine, the white pieces were really bothering me, so I decided to fussy cut around that. And I tell you, with being sick, my fine motor skills are really bad. So I don't know if you can tell, but it's not very straight how I cut. I almost have a little bit of a shake with this cold, but it's fine. I mean, nobody's really going to notice. You'll all notice because I pointed it out, but anyways. So I'm just going to pop up that sewing machine. The other thing that I found really hard with this particular image is all of the white on the bottom of the sewing machine. And I thought maybe I'd try coloring it in, but I didn't want to wreck it, so I left it. But I wish that they hadn't have left the bottom of that sewing machine white. Anyways, so to finish off the card, I'm just using 3 spools of thread. And then I'm going to play around with the sentiment here that says, you're so cute, adorable. I mean, how many more puns could they possibly think of? And of course, I'm going to play around with it, but it's going to go where I first had it, which is that bottom right-hand corner. So I'm not sure why I even bother changing around. I don't know if any of you do that as well. But you kind of always second guess yourself, and then you end up doing what you were going to do in the first place. So to try to break up some of this white, I decided to use my glitter brush marker on that as well. And it looks cute in person, but I really wish, I don't know, if you guys have any ideas to how to fix that white bottom, let me know. So card number 5. Okay, so when I opened up this package and saw all the little candies in there, I just thought they were so adorable. And I noticed that they had these all sorts, because they're like a licorice candy. And they're my mom loves these at Christmas time. She always gets a box at Christmas time. So I decided to do a card for her inspired by those little candies. So that's how the background for this card came about. You'll see in a second here, I'm going to bring in one of the little pieces of candy, and I'm going to show you kind of how the design came about. So I'm just trying to get these black pieces the way I want them, and I decided that I wanted them a bit thinner than when I had tried to put them on when it was facing down on my craft mat. So I just fixed that up. Here's the candy. So you can see there's like candy color on the top and on the bottom, and then the white filling has black licorice on either side. So that's how I decided to do this card. Here's the sentiment: you're all sorts of awesome. And then here are all the little candies that you would find in those boxes of all sorts. So I know in Canada, ours are like a yellow box. And I know my mom will get a kick out of this card. So I just had to make this for her, but so stinking cute. So I wanted to make sure I had an odd number of candies on there, just because we know when you're thinking of designing, odd is often more pleasing to the eye. So I kind of wanted them spread out. I didn't want them in a straight line, because I thought that that would have been too symmetrical and not very exciting. So I grouped most of them in two, although because there's 7, there's the one odd man out, and I made that the blue one there to the top right. But I did want them all touching, so you'll see here I have to fix those ones, because those two on the left are not touching the other ones, so they kind of look like they were floating out to the left. So I just fixed that up so that they were all kind of sitting there together. And I popped all of those up on foam adhesive, as well as the sentiment. Then I'm just going to ground this using C1, but my marker is like pretty much completely dried out. So I just gave it a little bit of shadowing and got out the blender pen as well, which helped a little bit, and then it'll just dry back, but it just gives it a little something so they don't look like they're floating. So on to card number 6, I'm just showing you, originally I thought I was going to kind of have them look like they were on a hill with the takeout paper, and then I really didn't like that, so I decided that I was going to use that busy kind of paper to the top. But that's why you see there's that chunk out of it. So I wanted to show you why there was a chunk out of it, because originally I had thought I would do this differently. But in the end, I really like how this turned out. So I've got the pink heart paper on the bottom, and then this red strip between the two, which I think just ties in all of the red. And this sentiment is, "Can I take you out?" And again, so cute. I decided to cut out the white bit of paper in between the handle and the top of the container. And so I just feel like that finishes it off and just makes it look even cuter. Something so simple, but you can really see that handle now. So I'm just going to line these up on this card. I do not eat sushi at all. But I know someone who does, so she will probably be getting this card. And I mean, those little sushis with the heart are so cute. But yeah, it's not my thing. So anyways, this card is done. I'm going to just adhere the sentiment onto it, and that'll be it. I don't add any extras on this card at all. I think it's cute just the way it is. Card number 7 is super simple. So I really liked this black paper with, it's got tiny dots with all the different colors in the collection. And I just thought it was adorable. Very simple. I'm going to cut out an oval using my stitched oval die. I'm going to just kind of throw that right on the card. And basically that's the design element of the card. I mean, it doesn't get any easier. But the thing with the Doodlebug collections is I find that they're so cute that you don't have to do a lot with them for them to turn out to be really sweet cards. So this one is all of, I love you, olive, you know, I love you, but with an olive. And so there's two little olives on there and that's it. But how cute is that? So card number 8, I wanted to do a bit of a border here. So I used a rectangle die and a kind of scalloped frame die. And then I'm just using two different pieces of paper. Well, the blue one's actually just a cardstock cut down to 4.25 by 5.5. And then this really pretty flower paper is really busy. So that's why I thought the white frame would really help kind of tone down the busyness of the paper. Sorry, I just had a bit of a cough and had to take some water. So this one is so cute. The little sentiment says, friends stick together. And it's got the little tape dispenser and the glue bottle. And then I'm just going to finish this off with 3 hearts. So a blue one, a yellow one, and a red one to match the colors in the tape and the glue. I did use a liquid glue for this because I knew I was going to want to play around. So it's a good thing I did, because I didn't get it in the right place where I wanted it when I first stuck it down. So that gave me enough leeway that I could get those into place, and then I just had to add some glue at the top there where it didn't quite get adhered down well enough. So that's that card. Super cute. And then we're going to move on to card number 9. So card number 9, I'm using this new to me die from MFT. It's a stitched edge die and it leaves stitch detailing. So what I decided to do was to put the one piece of paper over the other, cut it from a stitched rectangle die, and then cut it with this what would you call this shape? Like kind of a triangle, you know what I mean? I don't know what you would call it. You tell me down below what you would call it. Oh my goodness, my brain. So yeah, I have no idea what to call that. It's like a triangle has 3 sides, not only has 2, but a right angle, but it's not fully a right angle. Anyways, moving on. So I cut them both at the same time so it would have the exact same, so it would line up perfectly. So I thought that I wanted to use this little pea in the pod. It says, you make me so happy. Again, adorable. But I really couldn't get this to work. So I'm going to play with this. You saw me there as I was trying to figure out what that shape was. I brought in some circle dies, some oval dies, just out of white cardstock, trying to see if I wanted to use those. And in the end, I don't really like anything I do with these little peas, so I am going to move them to the side, and I'm going to bring in a different... I'm going to bring in different images here. I'm going to use the juice boxes instead of the peas, just because I found it a bit easier, the juice boxes, with the 2 of them. But you'll see here, I still do struggle with the placement of them. Like, I kind of wanted the sentiment to go there, but then I felt like it covered up the whole reason why I did that design element, which I end up covering even more. You'll see here when I finally decide on what it is I'm gonna do. I mean, really, any of these versions of how I'm playing around with this would be fine, so you could choose whichever one you like the best. But in the end, I end up putting them kind of up in the center. So then you can't really tell that that dips, but it's okay. I mean, you can't win them all. So that's kind of the design element I'm going for. I played around with this one forever. I don't know if it's just a bit as well. By the time you get to card number 9, you're kind of getting a bit tired and running out of ideas. And so I think I myself tend to struggle a bit more as kind of we get down the line on the cards. So I have these hearts played around yet again on where I wanted to place them. And I moved that pink one around a zillion times. And I think I put it back pretty close to where I had it the first time I laid it down. And then I decide to scratch that totally, and I bring those Illustrated Faith blue enamel hearts back. And I just feel like that pop of blue really helped pick up the blue flower paper that I used at the bottom of this card. So I'm just gonna play around with these. Oh my goodness. I think sometimes we could drive ourselves silly with how much we fuss with things. But anyways, okay, so on to card number 10, the final card. And I did this so backwards. I don't know if this was sick brain or just not thinking brain, but what I should have done was adhere that piece of paper to the card base and then die cut the entire thing with that stitched rectangle die instead of the way I did it. I mean, it worked out. I was lucky. I actually got it on there perfectly, but you'll notice here that I am using my liquid glue because I didn't have confidence in myself that I would get it right the first time, but I did. So I was pretty excited about that because at this point I was like, why didn't I just adhere that down to the bottom of the card and cut it all out at once? Anyhow, so then I cut some yellow cardstock with that stain with the same rectangle die, and I'm going to put that in place so that it's actually adhered to the inside panel of the card. So when you open it, you'll see that there. And then I'm going to use three little gummy bears. I'm going to pop them up on some foam adhesive, and I'm going to have them so that when you open the card, you can still see them, which I thought was cute. I mean, this is not a new technique by any means, but it's not one that I do very often. So I thought it was a bit fun. I really wanted that pink one in the middle, but if you'll notice, that green gummy bear, it seems bigger, and I don't know if it's because the white space around it is bigger. So it looked better in the middle, and really it doesn't matter how they sit, but I just thought the pink broke up the blue and the green. But anyways, so the sentiment here is I love you very much, which is so cute. And again, do I want to move this or do I want to just put it where I had it in the first place? And yes, I wanted it where I had put it in the first place. So just going to add a little bit of glitter to these guys, and then I use my black gel pen and I'm going to just darken up their eyes a little bit. And then I felt like their noses were really lost, so I took my R20 Copic marker and I just made them have pink little noses just so that you could see the noses better. And that's card number 10. So just going to go through these cards now, one by one. If you have a favorite, please let me know. It's always so much fun. And I would like to also send one of these cards to a lucky viewer. So if you would like one of these Doodlebug cards from me, all you have to do is leave a comment, tell me which one is your favorite. I may not necessarily be able to send you which one was your favorite, but I will try. And don't forget to like this video. And if you haven't subscribed, please consider subscribing. I do 10 card videos quite frequently, especially with Doodlebug. And don't forget, if you want to get 10% off your purchase, go over to Not Too Shabby Shop, use coupon code GEN10, it's GEN with two N's. You get 10% off your total purchase, which is great. If you're not familiar with Not Too Shabby, there's also a rewards program, so don't forget to create an account. Thanks everybody for watching. You guys are great. Thanks for putting up with me while I was sick. I really wanted to get this up though, so thanks for watching everybody. Take care. Bye.